The AGM-114 Hellfire. We're just going to go ahead and read it real quick, and then we're going to talk about it. The AGM-114 Hellfire is an air-to-ground missile, or AGM. That's what AGM stands for. First developed for anti-armor use, later developed for precision drone strikes against other target types, especially high-value targets. Don't get ahead of me. It was originally developed under the name Hellborn Laser and Fire and Forget Missile, which led to the colloquial name Hellfire, ultimately becoming the missile's formal name. It has a multi-mission, multi-target precision strike ability and can be launched from multiple air, sea, ground launch platforms, including the Predator drone. The Hellfire missile is the primary 100-pound, or 45 kilos if you don't have your flag on the moon, classed air-to-ground precision weapon for the armed forces of the United States and many other nations. It has also been fielded on surface platforms and surface-to-surface and surface-to-air roles. Now, you may have seen my video about the JAGM, which is the Joint Air-to-Ground Missile, which is supposed to be replacing the Hellfire. It's going to take some time, so we're going to have a lot of these in our inventory in case we sell them to somebody or use them. Fuck around and find out. Each Hellfire costs roughly $150,000 apiece. They are 100 pounds each, 64 inches in length, and 7 inches in diameter. The several variants of the warhead, they have high explosive anti-tank, shape charge, tandem charge, anti-armor, metal augmented charge, blast fragmentation. It can kill a lot of stuff in a lot of different ways. It has a solid fuel rocket motor inside of it. Its maximum speed is Mach 1.3. Its guidance system is a semi-active laser homing millimeter wave radar seeker, which is a fancy way of saying that a radar guides it in. This thing can be launched off a rotary wing, fixed wing, Predator drones, even the vertical launch system on the United States Navy Aegis system. They even have a way to fire this thing off of a tripod. Originally designed in 1974, they've been using these since then all the way up to now, but they haven't stopped designing them. They've had different variations, like the AGM-114 Romeo Hellfire. It entered service in late 2012, and it uses a semi-active laser homing guidance system and a K-charge multi-purpose warhead. And there is no way for me to explain that. The variations of the Hellfire, the AGM-114A, B, and C, F, FA, Interim Hellfire, the K, K2, K2A, Hellfire 2, the Hellfire Longbow, the Hellfire 2 Blast Fragmentation, the Hellfire Mac, the AGM-114P, Hellfire 2 for UAS, the AGM-114R, Hellfire 2, Hellfire Romeo, and the M36 Captive Flight Training Missile. And here comes the part that I really wanted to talk to people about. The AGM-114R9X. I'm going to just read you this, and then I'm probably going to make some jokes about it. This is just the way it's going to go. The Hellfire R9X is a Hellfire variant with a kinetic warhead with pop-out blades instead of explosives, used against specific human targets. Its lethality is due to 45 kilogram, 100 pounds of dense material with 6 blades flying at high speed, Mach 1.3, remember that. To crush and cut the targeted person, the R9X has also been referred to as the Ninja Missile. The Flying Ginsu. You know, the names they have in here really suck. We're going to go over that here in a second. It is intended to reduce collateral damage when targeting specific people. Deployed in secret in 2017, its existence has been public since 2019. This variant was used in the killing in 2017 of Abu Khayyar al-Masari, a member of Al-Qaeda's leadership, and in 2019 of Jamal Ahmad Mohammed al-Bawadi, accused of mastermind of the 2000 USS Cole bombing. It was also used in Afghanistan against a Taliban commander. Okay, so here's the thing. Someone in Skunkworks or DARPA or just the CIA underground, like, they had a problem. They're like, all right, we have this missile and we want to use it on specific targets, but we don't want to cause collateral damage. Now, to me, the logical thing is, just don't have a payload. It's traveling at Mach 1.3. I'm sorry, but if something hits a person at Mach 1.3 that is 60 inches in length, is 7 inches in diameter, it's going to kill me. But no, that wasn't enough for the United States. They decided, knife missile. That's what the fuck we need, is a knife missile. Somebody somewhere in a research and development area said, I want to put knives on a missile. What if someone's way over there and I want to stab them at Mach 1.3. And everybody else in the room was just like, you know, he's got a fucking point. What if we need to stab somebody way over there? So the R9X Hellfire is a really long drawn out name. The knife missile is not as funny as it could be, but given that it's a Hellfire, I have a couple of potential things instead of the flying Ginsu or the ninja missile, which are both really uncreative. So my suggestion for my number one pick is going to have to be the Satan Stabber. Number two, the Demon Dagger. Number three, Lucifer's lightsaber. I know that one took a little bit of an ingenious leap, but I think it'll work. Number four, Freedom Flechette. Look, my main problem is that this variation of the Hellfire doesn't have any fire with it, so I think we should call it something else. I'm even okay with Hellstabber. It's not my first pick, it's not even my last pick, but just something better. The AGM-114 has occasionally been used for air-to-air. It is a bit of a jack-of-all-trades when it comes to missiles. So in 2001, a Cessna 152 came from Lebanon into Israel and wasn't stating their intentions, wasn't talking to anybody. Well, Israeli AH-64 Apache attack helicopter hit it with a Hellfire, and I believe it says exactly here, resulting in its complete disintegration. I think that's probably the best way to sum up what a AGM-114 Hellfire can do. We've had Hellfires for a long time. We're switching over to the JAGM. You guys let me know what kind of weapon systems you want me to talk about next. As always, do not give in to the 22 a day. Every single one of you are amazing. And whether you're here from BTS Army or all of my military content, I appreciate the support. Play me out.